we said there are two parts. We have to define our access control policy, and then we have to do enforcement based on what is in that policy. Clearly, that policy defines who can access what and things like that. That kind of information, we're going to abstract that in a data structure that is called an access control matrix or an ACM. If it's a matrix, in this case, an access control matrix, that is going to abstract all the state that is relevant for making those access control decisions. Well, matrices have rows and columns. To define a matrix, you have to say what rows it has, what kind of columns it has, what does it store in each element or each cell of the matrix. So an access control matrix, rows are defined by the users or subjects that we have in the group. So rows actually correspond to the sources of requests or the subjects or the users. So this access control matrix, if Alice is a user in the system, there is going to be a row for Alice. Well, other thing that a matrix has to define this two-dimensional matrix we are talking about is we have to define its columns. Rows correspond to users. Actually, columns going to correspond to resources that we have in the system. So each resource that needs to be protected, remember, we need to know who's allowed to access it or not. So this matrix is sort of telling you for a given user, that's a row, and a given resource or object, what can be done. So the columns are going to correspond to all the resources that need to be protected in the system. So an access control matrix, since I'm talking about rows and columns and its two dimensions, any particular entry or cell in this matrix can be defined by what we have here, U, O, where the row that is corresponds to user U and the column for object O. So you start with a user, continue until you get to the object that we're talking about. So that element of the matrix or cell of the matrix is actually going to define what kind of access rights user U has for object O. So if this was a file and the access rights can be read, write, or execute, whatever subset of those access rights, then we're saying the entry in the matrix, if you look at the row for user U and object O, is going to say if U can read this object O. R is present in that entry, that means the user can read object O. Matrix, access control matrix, is based on users we have in the system, resources we have in the system, and the state actually it captures is who has what kind of access for the resources of the system. That's what each entry of the matrix is going to answer a question for a given user and a given object or resource.